Hi, it's me. I'm back. Welcome back, or welcome if this is the first time you're watching a video of mine. In my last video, I had a different background, but I'm kind of back to the background that I started with, solely because the light, it's really dependent on the lighting, and I don't have a whole lot of space for filming that gives me the best light. So we're back to the door. I'm trying to hide the doorknob because I obviously don't love the way that looks in my old videos, but it's there. It is what it is. So I'm just back to where I am, but hopefully maybe it's a little different. Maybe it looks a little nicer. Probably it doesn't, but this is what I'm working with. This is what we're going with. So, but if you're new, I just kind of talk about whatever I want to talk about, which isn't a whole lot. It's not a whole lot. I enjoy doing fashion reviews. That's kind of what I started my channel with. I also then was wanting to talk about perfume because I've gotten into that recently, and I just want to talk about it because this is my channel and I just want to talk about what I want to talk about. So I finally did find a designer that I really am just so excited about. So I'm going to be reviewing them today. The designer is Christopher John Rogers, and we're going to be doing the spring 2021 ready to wear line because we're really looking at 2021 now. So the spring 2021 lines have started coming out now. That's just how the fashion cycles work. Not like I am an expert and I know them by heart, because I truly do not. This line came out earlier in October, I think the first week of October, but the 2020 lines are coming out now for spring summer. So whenever I was looking at designers to review, I just kind of wanted to find a line that really I connected with, and this is one that really just made me happy looking at. I'm not a full color person. This is about as much color as I like to do. I like black with pops of color, but I always admire and I love collections that go full force in color, and Christopher John Rogers is a brand that really gravitates towards color and very fashion forward lines. So Christopher John Rogers is a relatively new brand to the fashion world, but just as a quick little background, Christopher John Rogers is a Louisiana born designer, and he went to SCAD in Savannah, Georgia. He has won a CFDA award either a year ago or 2 years ago. I'm not 100% sure, but he's dressed Tiana Taylor, he's dressed AOC, dressed Cardi B and SZA, along with a longer list of people. But his designs are very centered in the 80s, but has a very fresh take. It's a lot of experimentation with proportions, with color, with texture, and takes a classic but modern approach on dressing the woman's body. It's very classic, but also has really modern elements to it. Classic in the way that they're structured but have a lot of room for individuality, creativity, expression, and they're just something that I feel like a lot of people are going to gravitate to, should gravitate to, and they just have their own just unique stamp on them. And I really, really enjoyed the collection that I'm going to review today. And with that being said, I'll go ahead and get started. Obviously, since there's a going on, New York Fashion Week obviously had to do a little something different. So there have been some shows. I'm not 100% sure the level of safety behind any of them. I'm sure that they have tried to do their best with safety. With Christopher, this collection with Christopher John Rogers, it's just the campaign pictures in the studio. So I'll have them in right beside me here. But normally whenever I do my reviews, I do like to have the video of the runway, just because you can kind of get a better sense of the garment as a full look. And sometimes campaign pictures, you can only see the front side, not always the back side, or sometimes they'll take a picture of the back of the shirt but not show the whole outfit. So sometimes you don't get the full effect, but obviously with a going on, being able to do a really beautiful campaign photo shoot, it works for me, it's gonna work for everybody, it's gonna work. So again, I'll just have the pictures here, but I'll go ahead and get started. Okay, so this first dress right here is really fun. It's not something that I would exactly wear or want to wear. This is what I was talking about with, it's very simplistic, but it's got life to it. It's got something fun and interesting to it with it just being a sheath dress. I don't know how much you can see, but the cups of the top have seams that go around. It kind of reminds me of the Madonna bra, this dress has a very 80s vibe, 80s element to it, which I just think is really fun. And it's highlighter yellow, so yeah, there it is. Another highlighter look, which I really love this picture just in general. I think it's absolutely stunning. I think this is super interesting. It's again not something like I would wear. I obviously tend to wear black, but I always, like I said before, I always love people who do love color. I think that's just, I don't know, I just admire it. I just don't do it. But I do love just this simplistic, like, oversized blazer, very reminiscent of 80s women's workwear, which I think it's really fun. But yeah, I love just the styling of this overall. Okay, this dress, I definitely can see, when I see this dress, it definitely reminds me of Zendaya. I mean, everything reminds me of Zendaya because I love her so much. But I really love the shape of this balloon heart-shaped skirt. I think that's really fun. I love pieces that take a little bit more risk and have more fun. So I always gravitate towards really interesting silhouettes, and this is one of them. And this print is so much fun. It just has a lot of happiness to it. Okay, so this outfit is kind of what I was talking about with, I don't quite understand just based off of a picture how this is supposed to look, but I do love the structured shirt a lot. I don't know how oversized it is, if it's meant to be more of a jacket or a structured shirt, a structured button-down shirt. That's what it looks like, but it also kind of has an oversized element to it, so I can't really tell if it's meant to be one or the other. And then with the skirt below, again, I don't know if that's a dress and I don't know if it's a skirt, but I'm just gonna go with maybe it's a dress. But I think it's cute, I like it. I don't have a whole lot more to say about that because again, there's not much I can really see, but it's still fun. This dress, I really love this dress. I could see Tracee Ellis Ross wearing this outfit, and if we get to a point where we can safely do red carpets again, I really hope in some fashion or another Tracee Ellis Ross wears this, because I think this is so fun. I love the ruffles. I love the stacked ruffled part. I think that's just so fun. And the print, it's just art. I love it. Okay, so this is just a tank top and tailored pants, but I really love the loopholes and the pockets that have the details of the colors. That's what I mean with his line have the foundation of simplicity, but then elevates it in modern ways. And I know, like, oh, you just put color on things, but I don't know, like, it's just sometimes if the wheel isn't broke, don't fix it, but that doesn't mean you can't paint it. This dress is really cute. I don't have a ton to say about it, but I do love the collar. It might be a little hard to see in the picture, but I love the big oversized collar with the tons of ruffles. I just think that's a lot of fun. And I also really do like the broader shoulders. Again, kind of throwing it back to the 80s, which I really like. And also I was reading about some trends, and this kind of hits a few boxes with some spring trends that I was reading with fun day dresses and broad shoulders. So this was hitting a few trends, which if you wanted to know that, you do now. This top, I really like it. The skirt, I'm not 100% in love with, but you can't like everything, but I really like this top. Just a like I said, back to the basics, white button-down top, but the design are crystals. I don't know, I can't remember if they were like Swarovski crystals or whatever, but I really think that design is fun. And I like that on that shirt. This I think is a lot of fun. I can't tell if this is supposed to be a catsuit, a midi dress, or a maxi dress, just a sheath version of that. But I love the sportiness, kind of athleisure, but kind of has a little bit of a 60s, 70s vibe to it with the color blocking. It just kind of reminds me of a Bond girl, and I think it's really pretty. I like it a lot. And I like the, if I'm seeing this correctly, it looks like a softer fabric, which I really do like that a lot. Again, we've got another very bright pantsuit. And this also, the pants was something that's supposed to be kind of on trend for spring 2021 with the breakaway from very fitted pants, things that are a little bit looser and a little bit more easier to work with, which I'm no, I for myself, like, I can get on board with that very easily. And I would actually really like those pants. I probably would not wear it with the blazer just because that much color would give me a heart attack. But I really think those pants are super fun. This does not, like, rock my socks, but I do think it's really pretty. It's just, this isn't my gig, but I think it's really interesting, but I don't really have much more to say other than that. This, I think, is really pretty. I would definitely really love to see this at an award show or some event of some sort. I love that it's really simple and kind of classic in the fact that it's very simple, but just because it's simple does not take away from anything. I think it's really lovely. I love that train. Again, this kind of reminds me of that 60s, like the higher waist dresses from the 60s. Kind of that empire look. I really wish I could see the front of this dress because I would be interested to know what that looks like. I think this one's really cool. I like the quilted aspect of it. It's kind of hard for me to visualize somebody wearing this one. I would definitely could imagine some celebrities would wear this. I'm just trying to, like, think of where, who, and for what event. So, yeah. Like, I think this one's really cool. I'm having a little trouble figuring out who I would want to wear this. But I think it's very fun. I like the quilted dress and the buttons all the way down. I think that's really interesting. This one's also really fun. Again, I don't know where I could see this at. But I could see somebody, again, I don't know who, just because I don't really follow a ton of celebrity fashion enough to say, this is who I could see wearing this. I'm not sure who I want to wear this, but I do think this would look really cool at an event. I'm just not sure what event. It looks really toned down, and I kind of love when people wear kind of toned down, elevated looks to places that maybe people would be wearing more formal things, if that makes sense. This one I like. I'm not in love with it, and I'm just gonna move on. This one, I don't have much to say because I only see the sleeve. I do love the sleeve. I just wish I could see the rest of the shirt to have more of an opinion on it. This pantsuit I do really like. I really love the oversized lapels. I love the oversized sleeves. And I like that the pants are a little looser but still have a structured look to them. So I really do like this look quite a lot. This shirt I really, really, really like. As soon as I saw it, I was like, I would 100% buy this shirt. And yes, that they do kind of look like nipples, but whatever. I would absolutely buy this shirt. I would wear this shirt. I like the fact that it's very bright, but for somebody like myself who loves wearing black, I like that there's enough black in there that it isn't so overwhelmingly full of color. This dress right here. I only can hope that we get to a point where we can safely do red carpets again. I absolutely need somebody to wear this on the red carpet. Like, I need somebody to wear this on the red carpet. I love this so much. It has such a fun 70s element to it with the chevron, but the oversized chevron striped colors and this kind of effortless top that kind of flows down into a train. I love it. And I love this black sash that kind of just pulls it all together. I love it. I won't stop thinking about this one. This I really like. I think this is so cute. This gives me like 80s vibes and like New York 80s vibes. I really like this a lot. I could see, honestly, like, weirdly enough, like, I could see Cardi B wearing this. Can you imagine? Like, she would just look so good in this. I don't know if she would want to wear this. I don't know if it's totally her style, but I just, like, would like to see her wearing this in, like, a music video. I think that would look really fun. This dress I really like too. I wish I could see the front of this, but I love the blues in this mixed with the red in it. I think it's really fun, and I like the knit, which is another trend I saw. Just letting you know. Which was this, they called it second skin knits, which, I don't know, I thought that was fun. But this looks just really cozy, and I too would also want to buy that. Okay. I want to make one thing clear. This outfit will never not be burned into my memory. I cannot express enough to you how in love with this outfit I am. I mean, do I need to say much about it? Because you have oversized floral, oversized stripes. You have the teeniest amount of black in there that soothes my soul. And it works. It just works. I just love it. I can't say much more about that, but I love it. This, I think, is really fresh and clean. I really love this. I love the simplistic button-down tunic look. I think that's really fun. I don't think I've seen a whole lot of that before, so I really like it in this, and I love the different pops of color. I think that's really fun. Oh, this one. I really like this one, too. That is so pretty. This trumpet skirt with the oversized stripes. That just looks so fun. It's just, it makes you happy. I really like that one a lot too. This I really like. Now this really sings to my heart. Something completely black, but with a ton of little multicolored jewels on there. It's just, it really speaks to me. I love the oversized collar. I don't know if I would actually wear this because I don't know how I would look in an oversized collar, but I really love this shirt. It looks so fun. And I would love to see more things like this come 2021. If anybody's listening, be inspired. This one I really, 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 really like too. I don't know what to say about it, but I really like it. I know that I said that the trend was kind of breaking away from more slimmer styled pants. I will always love a straight leg or a slimmer leg pant, and I love these fun dots of colors. I think that's just really cute. I just wish I could afford this. I don't know what else I can say about this. I really love it, and I truly wish I could afford it. I think that's just so fun. I don't know if I'd actually wear that together because I feel like on me it would look really silly, but I love it on her. I feel like she looks really cute in it, and people who have a better sense of style than me would look really great in that. I really love this dress too. I think this is definitely reminds me of some of the other lines that I've seen from him. Very big ball gown skirts with really structured tops. Like, I really like that a lot. Again, I love the detail of color and that is put into it. I think it just looks so pretty. Again, another one that I would love to see on a red carpet or an event somewhere safely. This one, I like this one. I just can't get a sense of what it is, but I do like the idea of it. I don't think that makes sense, maybe, but I like it. I don't love it. I kind of want to get a better sense of what it's going on here. This one I think is really pretty. I think this one's really, like, it's cute. It feels like spring. When I see this, I just think of Central Park in the spring, which, not like I've been to Central Park during the spring, but I could just imagine myself in this dress with a little picnic basket. I don't know, it's just really cute. It's just really romantic, and I like it. I think it's really pretty. This one is super fun. This definitely has 80s New York vibes. That's just what I get from it. I just feel like somebody cool needs to wear this as well. This shirt is just, it is a statement. You have to know who you are if you're wearing this shirt. This dress, oh my gosh. I was really in my head just contemplating, like, maybe you should figure out how to get it. There's no way. I do not have that kind of money. There's absolutely no way. But I love monochromatic looks. Even though this is monochromatic, I love the bust, the tiny bit of color there. I think that's really pretty. And I love the oversized sleeves. I love an oversized sleeve. I hope that stays. I know trends come and go, but I hope the oversized sleeve stays for a little longer. But I love this ballooning kind of skirt that I feel like if you twirled in it, it would just be so magical. I really love this dress. I really cannot think about it because I will find a way to buy this, and there's absolutely no way. There's no reason for me to buy it. There's no way that I could buy it, so I need to stop thinking about it. This one, I don't have too much that I would like to say about it. I absolutely think it's fun. It's interesting. I like the fact that it's cargo on a structured suit. Like, I don't think I've ever seen that before. But do I know if I would want to see it again? I'm not sure. But I'm not knocking it. I think it's really fun. I just don't know if I have much more to contribute to that. But it's fun. It's interesting for sure. This is such a good look. I think it's just the same pants as before, but I love this top. Yeah, it's, I mean, I don't have much more to say about the top, but I think this picture is really fun. I like it a lot. This outfit though, I really do like. More so the skirt than the oversized blazer. I like the oversized blazer, and I like the oversized blazers in this collection, but this skirt in particular, I personally have been seeing a lot of pleating happening in collections, and I'm a sucker for pleated skirts. I think they're just so pretty. I love twirling in them, and I really need to actually get some more pleated skirts. I don't have any, but I used to wear them a ton. But this is just so pretty, and I love the all over blue. This is just really, really pretty. Again, this is one that I need to keep moving on, because my brain will figure out a way to make it make sense to have this and spend money on it. And I don't have that kind of money. Like, I love how delicate the pleating is, and then it's just flowing away. I could see so many people wearing something like this, but yeah, you would still look so individual, if that makes sense. And this is one. I need to see somebody wearing this. This is such a badass jumpsuit. The checkered side and then this abstract marbly black and white side. I wish I could see the front of this one, but this is one where I don't even need to see the front of it to know that this whole thing is just killer. I love it. I absolutely love it. And this dress too. This is another dress. Those two right there, there's one influencer in my mind that I could totally see that person wearing these. Actually a couple, but I really would love to see a few people wearing these two, because I think they are so interesting and so fun. And this one too. Oh my, I'm kind of nearing the end of this collection, but the last several outfits of this collection, I absolutely love them. I love this midi. This midi dress, oh my god, this is just fun. This one just makes me happy. The colors, the checkered at the bottom, like the proportion of colors, it's just everything about it is so right. And this one too, I really like this one a lot too. Again, it has like that circle nipply looking thing going on, but I like it, and I like the different sections of color, like the red, the black and white, and then the blue. I like how that flows. It looks really fun. And then this one. When I saw this, it reminded me of Michelle Obama. It 100% reminds me of Michelle Obama and her portrait in the White House portrait. But the portrait of her, like, I'll have the picture side by side here for a second just to show you like why it reminded me of that. But this dress alone is just, it's just a happy dress. I love it so much. And last but not least, we have this. I'm not 100% sure. I like this a lot. I'm not really sure what I have to say about this. I think it's really interesting, absolutely. But it is if somebody were to wear this, it would be a statement for sure. But it is really fun. It's really cool. But yeah, with that, we are done. I kind of flew through a few, just like I said, because if I don't have anything to say about it, then there's really no point in me just labbing on about it. But overall, I really love this collection. I know I've said it a million times already, but it's really just full of life. And I know that we can all agree that 2020 has been very dark for many reasons. So many reasons, and I don't think that should just be brushed over or anything, but I do like seeing this collection kind of bring a little bit of light and kind of hope and optimism for the future. Like I said, nothing needs to be brushed over. There's a lot that needs to be addressed with 2020. But I just like the fact that this collection is just energetic. It's lively, it's fun, it's simple. I really do feel that a lot of these pieces, anybody could wear. There's something in it for everybody. If you have the money for that, I wish I did. But there's just an effortlessness to them, an ease to them. There's a lot of creativity that you can see that's been put into this, and I really, really do love it. I cannot say it enough. But with that being said, I will go ahead and end it here. Hopefully you stayed along for the ride. But yeah, thanks for joining me, and I'll see you in the next video.